Hi, Laliditions. How you guys doing? Hi, my Laliditions. How you guys doing? Today's video is a couple tag, as I'm sure you have seen the topic. And we both are going to be your hosts in this video. And of course, we're going to be taking you through our relationship journey. So you guys are going to know how we both met. Today, my husband is here with me today. Yeah. How do you feel?
Feeling fine.
So guys, you guys requested for this video. You said you want to see a couple tag. So we both decided that, okay, we have to make time to do this together because on the way to pulling. So guys, you guys are going to encourage us and make sure you like this video, share it, and you know, just have fun watching the video. Let us know what you think in the comment section, and if you can relate to what we're talking about, signify by raising your hands. Okay. So we're moving to the main discussion now. So how did we meet?
Hello, Laliditions viewers. My name is Deji. I'm the husband to Lalidi.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching and subscribing to our channel.
Calm down, some drink.
I really appreciate you all.
Yeah.
So let's go straight to how we met. How I met this pretty angel.
Yes. Angel of mine.
We're doing our masters at Coventry University. 2017, during our induction period, that was the first time I saw her.
Yeah, I remember that
and
day.
And her sister walked in.
Yeah, I remember that day.
And we were just like, are these people from Nigeria or from other African countries? They isolated themselves from us, so they sat down in different. So we met, first time I met her was during our induction. So I saw her and her sister, they came in. That was the first time I met her. I was like, ah, she's beautiful, but there was no string attached due to the fact I was in a relationship back in Nigeria. I was like, oh, she's a beautiful girl. That's it. Second time I met her was when she was coming from the hub. I think I was going home. I was going home that day. So she was coming from distance and I was approaching her and I discovered that this is not the lady in my class. I walked past her. I saw Bola in school. I was like, wow, I saw one girl, one lady. She looks exactly like you. Like,
what? Carbon copy.
Carbon copy. You guys look so much alike. She was just laughing. Like, I was like, what's wrong with her? Why is she laughing? She was like, this is my sister. I was like, oh, that's fine. Her sister is beautiful and everything. I was like, are you interested in my sister? I said, why would I be interested in your sister? I'm in a relationship, why would I be? So the third time I met her was, Bola invited me to a church. That was LCG, JCC.
JCC, okay? JCC, Jubilee Christian Center, Coventry. If you don't know that church, you don't know. Come on. No, that's a church.
Yeah. I told her that I've been in that church before. A friend of mine have introduced me to that church and I've gone to that church before. So I decided to show up on a Sunday. And when I showed up on a Sunday, so, you know, as a visitor now, when you come to church, it's not like your mind is ready in the service just to watch around and try to know how everything is. It's not like I come there to come and look for Bible.
We need to ask you.
Just like, let me just observe how they're servicing. So, we met in church. I met her in church. So, she was singing that day. I was like, wow. I love the way she was singing. And something directly in my mind told me that this pretty lady here, she's my wife. I don't know where that voice came from. But I know that's the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit talks to you, it talks to you in inside.
See this man. Holy Spirit was talking to him. People were raising their hands in worship. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And somebody was hearing his deep voice and was looking at woman.
I know when God talks to me and I have that gift.
Hallelujah.
I have the gift of instinct. When my instinct tells me something about a particular thing, it is.
But
at that moment, I was like, wow, is this not looking complicated? I'm in a relationship. though the relationship in Nigeria seems
complicated.
Complicated. Mm. And a lot of it's very, very complicated, which I'm just trying to manage. But and God is telling me that this is my wife and everything. So I was just like, okay, let the will of God be done. So that's how the service. But I asked me, how was the service? Oh, the service is fantastic. And I said, one thing, babe, I want to say you. You know what? Seems I like your sister. She was like, oh, you like my sister? Yeah, I love your sister. She was like, ah.
Okay.
Yes, Bola, I've been telling you I'm in a relationship, but the relationship is complicated.
Hmm.
Blah, blah, blah. So that she was not like, okay, no problem. That though her sister too is single, and blah, blah, blah. But she talks to her. And I said, no, don't talk to her. Do you know what you do for me? Tell her that I want to see her personally, that I have something to tell her.
And because, so, sorry, and then my sister came to me and told me in my ear that, oh, one of our friends in class, that he's a Nigerian, that he, the person said he would like to see my sister. That's how she put it, that the person wants to meet his her sister, rather. So I was like, okay, no problem. So she was like, oh, he insisted that he wants to see you after church.
Yeah.
So I said, oh, okay then, no problem. Yeah, so
so, and I'm someone that always, it's not like I don't believe in people telling, let me tell this person, I like this person. It's not I don't believe in it, but it's just my kind of person. I believe that what I want it.
Mm.
Because the Bible said, he who finds a wife has found a good thing, or something, mercy from God.
Mm.
And I believe anything I want, I go for it. I don't want you to share the glory or anything or never, I think. That's why I said, let me talk to her. The highest thing she will do is, I'm not interested. She can't slap me.
What if I gave you a death slap?
Well, in the modernized world, the way I was saying that, I see her like a matured person. Mm. And, you know, then I used to have this ego in me that a lady can't turn me down. No matter what. I've even met. Let's stop this, and easily it was easy. I mean, many people watching this will be like, oh, so this is no, that was not my story, but it's always good to look nice and But inside me, man, so scared.
Really
scared. Like,
I looking so hard to approach?
No. That, but every man would always feel that no matter it is, we met after service and I introduced my name to her, that my name is Aya Deji, that she can call me Deji, that I'm a sister's friend, a classmate, and that I would like her to be my friend. And if she doesn't mind that, we can be friends. And she told me that we are already friends. I said, I know, but yeah, actually, let me be real with you. I want you to be my friend, but along the line, everything can, you understand?
Like, it could, you were like, yeah, we could be friends, but it could even lead to something even better.
Yeah,
you just like my person and you want to be my friend. And I was like, oh, well, being my friend, you're already my friend because you're my sister's friend, so you're indirectly my friend.
Mm.
So there's really no problem about being your friend. And then,
so that was it. So I was like, oh man, this went really peaceful, like
smooth
than ever out there.
Until the blow. Are you guys ready to hear that part? Until I gave him a big blow.
Yeah, so I asked for a number. Babe, can I have your number? She said, what did you say?
He asked for my number and I was like, I'm sorry, I don't give my number to strangers.
Wow.
And he was like, okay, I'm not a stranger. I'm your friend. You just said it, that we're friends. I said, okay, yeah, we're friends, but I don't think I would like to give you my number. So he was now like, ah, so what if I want to call you, speak to you one-on-one, that don't you think me having your number would help us to be able to talk more and get to know each other better, like good friends and all of that. And I was like, anytime you want to call me, all you need to do is you could call my sister, and then, you know, she could just pass the phone to me because we are staying in the same house, and then I could always talk to you on there, like from my sister's phone. I think my guy felt it. But I was shocked that he asked one more time. I was shocked.
Yeah.
He asked again, yeah. And then he asked again. Because he was like, okay, yeah, you've said everything, but really, I think it's still going to be better if I have your number. And you know? I was like, I'm sorry. I don't want you to feel bad. I don't want you to see me like I'm one very bad person and stuff. But seriously, I'm afraid I cannot give you my number.
You know why I asked again?
You did that to see his face.
Why I asked again was that maybe what I said she didn't hear. You know, it's possible at times. So she might not hear it very well. So I have to say it again. Like,
okay,
your number. So and she said it again in a more polite manner. Seriously, that really got me a lot because I didn't know why. There's something there. Till today, I do ask myself, why didn't I open the diary that day and save that date?
What?
Like,
did it pain you that much? Like, it was so painful to you.
Yeah, because I haven't since when I was born. I've never. Since when I've been in asking babe out,
oh my god,
has never turned me down.
Okay, the record breaker. Come on,
because, yeah, she's a record breaker.
Hmm. Okay.
Well, why I accepted was that, well, actually, God was trying to tell me something there that you'll be going scot free when you were dating girls. He asked them, hey babe, I love you, give me your number straight away.
They give you,
feel fly,
you know.
I'm a fine boy.
You know now, you know.
Gave me a tough time. Made me value her more, made me respect her.
Mm.
Yeah, and also an advice to
young ladies, out there
watching me. He values you more.
When you give him tough time.
Not really, you're not giving that tough time, and
my own was really bad. I think
it
was like 2 months before I, right?
Yeah.
It was two and a half months.
Yeah. So let me continue. So and I said, okay, no problem. So I now went home. I got home. I was angry. What is this? Blah blah blah. Unfortunately, our sister called at that time. Hello. Hello, Deji. Have you spoken to my sister? Did my sister like you? Can you call? Because Bonali is someone that she wants to know everything.
My sister is very caring. That's just what it means.
Very caring. She wants to know, what is happening and everything. I said, man, your sister, man, seems this thing is going to be difficult. She's like, something about you. You are not patient.
Oh my God.
You need to be patient.
So I thought you patient.
Yeah. She taught me that. Yeah. Because at times I feel, maybe guess it's not another one. But why I was patient though is because my instinct and my spirit was telling me she was the one. So I was just like, I had to chill and listen to that spirit. So it was my birthday. Period. My birthday was fast approaching. If you want to know my birthday, you'll pay.
They don't have to know.
I was like, okay, I'm gonna spend my birthday with someone I love most. Got there, my sister brought out a gift. I saw the gift. I was so, wow, so lovely. So she brought out her gift, and that gave me the second shock.
Guys, you guys are very looking at me like I'm so bad. Like, what kind of girl is this? Let it go. Okay.
So she gave me the second shock. You guys know the first shock now.
Okay, the second
the
one.
The first
now.
Shock was.
Not the number. Mm-hmm.
The second shock was. So she gave me a birthday card. I was like, wow. So in all this thing, even though her sister That it's not like we are just friends. She gave me. I know you.
Hello, I wasn't dating you, man. I know people. So why were you expecting so much?
So why are you expecting so much? Yes. But I was already feeling like someone that I could have. That
you were dreaming.
Disclosed. I told her my intention.
What intention? You just told me you want to be my friend, man. Wait. So, fam, let me just tell you guys something. Let me just chip in something.
I'm not matured enough to know that.
See, it doesn't matter.
That's what I'm
saying. Girls, that's what I'm going to say. See. Even if you even like that guy, don't even show it like you like him. That is it. I already saw that this is a good guy, obviously, from the times he was coming around and stuff. But I was still praying about it. So, I didn't want to be forward. Yeah, his birthday was approaching. And do you not know the funny thing? That gift that my sister got for you, I was the one that chose it.
Wow.
We actually went to do the shopping together. Okay, and we picked it, and you never knew that. But because I personally told her that she should not let you know that, you know, we went together. But the only thing, when I was trying to get gift, I was like, let me just get him a card, because I don't want him to start having ideas in his head, like, you know, I don't want to give him ideas that it's okay, maybe this person likes you or something. So I was just like, please, I'll just give him a good card. And a card that comes from the heart is good, isn't it? And I gave him a good card. And here he is saying, oh, why did I just get him a card?
So when she gave me the card, I was like, yeah, 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 that is fine, 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 thank you very much. Mm-hmm. I was not like, yeah, I want to give you another birthday present. I was like, ah, madam, which birthday present be that? I was like, I want to give you my number. Wow.
He was so happy. It was like he won a jackpot. Oh! It was like, it was so... You needed to have seen his reaction. He was so happy, like. And I was like, okay. I didn't know he was going to take it that much, but... That particular day made me know how much he really wanted to be close to me, or how much he really wanted to be part of my life. I just thought to myself that, okay, since I wasn't able to really get him anything much, what do I think he's gonna really like? Because I'm this kind of person that if someone is my friend and you're close to me, I always like to do something for you on your birthday that you would always remember, or something that you love. You know, I'm that romantic, you know. I now tell myself that, okay, since I've been too tough with him, too harsh with him, it was time to take the whole thing to the next level. So I gave him my number. And it was happy.
So, that number was the best birthday gift
ever.
When she was doing masters, then our lectures are always in the evening, like 4 to 7. So she was telling that she has a class now.
Guys, I was a very serious student.
Yeah, she was a very serious
student. I'm not the type of person that because I'm now seeing one guy or I'm in a relationship, I will not have focus.
No.
And we never ever let lovey-dovey to affect my academics. Oh,
she went for lectures and by 7:30 she came. So I was still in the house waiting for her and her sister. So when she came back, you know, before lectures... She was in the room for like 2.5 hours. She left me and her sister alone. She was doing makeup. Imagine.
2.5? Oh my God. Did you just say that on camera? Hours. That's not true. That's not true.
I was left doing 2.5 hours. For a very Don't long mind him. Time.
Maybe an hour
she
plus.
She was dressing. You know, so when she came out, I was stuff. Like, wow. In my mind, I was like, she's doing makeup for me.
Who is doing makeup for you?
So when I
I've always been someone that loves makeup. So
when I went out, I was like, tell my sister, she's doing makeup for me. I was like, she loves makeup so much. I can get something like that. When she came back, so we headed to Cosmo at Coventry. So that's where they celebrated my birthday, and it was memorable.
Well, when we got to Cosmo, I also went to, because in Cosmo, right, there's a place you could actually walk up to one of the workers and tell them that, okay, can you guys do a surprise little something? Just, you know, put some candles on a small cake and then you guys play the happy birthday song and, you know, just surprise the celebrant. Boom. Mm. So that day, I was just, fam, you see what he was portraying me like, oh, I just got him a card. I had plans. I wanted to make him really happy. So apart from giving him number that day, I was like, I'm going to make this guy very happy and surprised, because I know all this while he was so patient with me and he just showed me another side, like, okay, for someone to be this patient, he's really serious with me, I will now show you that I'm not that bad. I'm a very sweet heart, okay?
Yeah.
So I told the lady, and then I just I just told him, I was like, I just want to ease myself and I'll be back. And that was when I used the opportunity to do that. And those people, they just, you know, surprised us, surprised him rather with it. And he was shocked, like, okay, who did this? Paula was like, no, that wasn't me. And I was like, okay, I did. And he was so happy. He has said his side of the story, so I'm going to say my side of the story. I saw this guy walk up to me, give me a number. No, I'm not ready to give you a number because... You know, we have a lot of fuck boys out there, you know. All these guys that are not ready to do anything. Maybe they just say, fine, babe, and then just want to strafe you, and then on to the next one. You know, that kind of thing. I had that kind of mentality, like, okay, this is just one of them. Because when you see a guy that is fine, there's something we call in Yoruba faworaja, you know.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a Yoruba lady, you can relate. This is what we call the Yoruba demons, yeah? So I was just trying to tread soft relationships. I've been like, most of the guys tell me, like, when you enter a place, gosh, everyone, and I'm inside, I'm feeling myself like, okay, you know, I have that presence. So because of that, I was really careful because some guys can just decide to plan for you, if you know what I mean. So I just told myself I really needed to be calm. So when he was coming around, I was like, who is this one again? What does he want? Why is he so much on my case? So I decided to not like punish him, but give it a long, long time. Before I finally say, okay, yes, let's get into a relationship. And of course, I prayerfully did it because even the period we were just talking like friends per se, yeah. I was praying, you know, I needed to find out, like, is this person a good person and is he the one for me and stuff like that. So there was this fateful day, I was not feeling too well and I was in the house and it was on a Sunday, I couldn't go to church and he was in church that day with my sister. My sister went to church that day.
Okay,
correct. So the Spirit of God told me that morning, like, just because most times when, before then he had always been telling my sister, I want to come and visit. And I told my sister, don't bring any man to the house, okay? Not that kind of elder sister that is so, you know, strict, like, hey, no. He wants to see me, you can see me anywhere else, not the house. Like, so... the Spirit of God was now telling me that I should tell her that if anyone says they want to come and visit me or greet me that day, that I should tell the person that there's no problem. The person can come and greet me. So I now told her. But apparently, my sister did not hear when I said that.
Yeah.
So she came back from church that day and she told me, ah, did you asked of you? And I said, oh, hey, yeah. Anyway, that was why I even said, that was why I even told you this morning that if he wanted to, you know, visit, he can come. And she was like, what? Did you actually say that? I didn't hear you say that. And I was like, well, I actually said that. She was like, wait, I'm coming. And I was like, come here. Do you know my sister ran and she went to go and call him?
Yeah,
like,
so
God. She went to call him that, CEO, your opportunity has come. Oh, my sister actually said, if you wanted to come, I didn't hear. If you know, are you interested in coming to check her? Just come. And you know, that was what he was giving me the gist later. That's why I can explain that. It's because I didn't know, I had no idea. I just saw that she was like, I'm coming. I didn't know what she was going to do. Not knowing she went to call him anyway. So she cut the long story short. He was coming around. So I want you to actually tell them that part where you had to, you know, dress in a certain way and look at yourself 100 times.
So actually, it was on a Sunday when she called me that, oh, my sister wants to see you and everything.
Wants to see you. Can you imagine?
And yeah, that's what she said.
Are you kidding?
No, okay. Like our sister said, if anybody wants to come and see her, that she can. But she had to bend it.
Because I wasn't feeling well.
You know, in Yoruba, they'll say it's not the way.
Yeah, exactly. The way I said it.
Question,
send you message.
That is Yoruba, danger, and everything. So she used sense to say it. She told me that. Lord Last said
she wants to see you.
She wants me to come to the house. So wow. And that day that I was like, okay.
Yeah,
I think one break and I was thinking of going to
work
or something to go and work.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, this is an opportunity. We'll suspend work. We'll go and
always know an opportunity when it comes, guys.
Yeah. I was dressed already, so I had to change. I had to have my bath. I spray all the pair if I could.
Did you actually do that? Do you want to choke me?
I was using Tom Ford, and Tom Ford is a very nice pair. So,
yeah.
So man, I have to dress nice. I have to dress like. So when I got to her place and all that, asking her sister, oh, why is my dressing? Hope I look nice. Hope I'm
because okay. Actually, it was my sister. I went to pick him because he didn't know the house. So when he actually got into the room and I saw him, fam, oh my god. To be honest, for the very first time, I was like, wow. I was like, wow. It was not like I've never seen, it was as if I've not seen him before. Like, my eyes became more open, like,
yes, that's wow. Spirit.
I don't know the kind of prayer he prayed, but come on. I saw him from his shoes, and then I looked down, up and down, like, okay, this is good. There's some good stuff.
Something that is always at the back of my mind. Even though when you're praying for someone you love and everything,
yeah,
there's always thing that you put at the back of your mind. You should be looking, you should always look presentable. It's not like, the man will see me,
I like you like that.
Even though you've prayed and the Holy Spirit has told you that this is the person, and the person has conviction, at least. And that's why there's an adage that the way you dress is the way people
address
you.
So guys, and one thing led to the other, and we started a relationship.
You see? Yeah. So after the lovely, jolly birthday, paparazzi, blah, 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 with the families and da, da, da. So we got talking on phone, we do video calls, we talk and everything. And then I knew
we clicked, in my
spirit.
Basically.
Yeah, we clicked. Mm-hmm. So I knew in my spirit that, yes.
And funny thing, he was now telling me that, oh, when he saw me on stage, that the Spirit of God told him that I'm his wife. And I was in my mind, I was like, we'll see about that.
I'm someone that is always focused wherever I'm going.
That's where you're going.
I'm going there. So, and I'm in a relationship which I need to call it a quit.
So
I had to call her and
babe. You had to trash that part.
This relationship can go further. So we trash that part, and because I have that personal conviction that this is my woman. Not today, married.
Thank God.
Happily married. But thank God.
So fam, that's it. That brings us to the end of the video. If you guys like it, make sure you like, you know, press that, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you guys share this video and make sure you guys tell us, you know, how much you can relate to everything we spoke about and everything we talked about in the video. And I'm going to see you guys in my next video. So for now, it's bye. Hi, Lolitisha.
Assurance, yeah. I give my baby assurance. I give my baby lifetime insurance.